starting with the topic testing of random number frequency. And in testing of random number frequency, it involves two tests. It is done by the two method, that is Kolmogorov-Smirnov test and the Chi-square test. The both tests are a statistical hypothesis test. That is valid to perform when the test statistic is chi-squared distributed under the null hypothesis as well as the KS test. These are the steps to compute the form to compute any given statements of the KS method. In step 1, rank the values according to the ascending order. In step 2, compute the parameters of D positive and D negative. And after that, to compute the D positive, to compute the formula of D positive is equal to I by N minus Ri, where I is between the 1 and N, where D negative formula is Ri minus I minus 1 by N. Now the third step is to compute the D, where max D positive comma D negative. In the fourth, there is a locate in the table critical value of D alpha for the specified level alpha in a sample N. And in the fifth step, D is greater than equal to alpha or not. If no difference is detected between, then the statement is a true and which lie under the condition of the uniform distribution. This Kolmogorov-Smirnov test is based on the largest absolute derivation between the fx and the nx over a range of a random variable. And there are two tests of testing of random number frequency, the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test and the chi-square test. And the next one is example of the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test. So this is a problem of the KS test, in which the sequence of the numbers 0.63, 0.49, 0.24, 0.57, 0.71, 0.89 has been generated use the KS test, and the alpha value which is given, that is 0.05, to determine if the hypothesis that the numbers are uniformly distributed on the interval 0,1 can be rejected. So first of all, we have to define here what is S1. S1, in a step 1, we define hypothesis. That is from algorithm. In the second step, arrange all the numbers in a ascending order. Arrange numbers in ascending order. It means whatever the number which is given here is arranged in ascending order. So we have order 0.24. After that, 0.49 is greater than equal to 0.57, is greater than equal to 0.63, is greater than equal to 0.71, and is greater than equal to 0.89. So this is the arrangement of numbers. Now in step 3, what we have to compute, we have to compute D positive and D negative value. So here we draw a table there, in which we define what is I. It is totally based on the formula which we seen earlier, Ri I by N D plus, whereas D negative. So what is the value of I? The total number of value. Total number of values. The total number of value is 6. Here the total number of values is 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what is I? That is the total interval of values. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this is I. And Ri, what is Ri? Ri is a distribution of all the number which we arranged here in ascending order. So this is a 0.24. In second step, 49 In the third time, we have written 0.57, 0.63, and for 5, sorry, 63, and for 6, 0.163, for 5, 0.71, and for 6, 0.89. So now we have to calculate by I by n. So what is I? I is a 1 and a 1 and n is equal to 6. This 6 n, total number of value is 6. So 1 by first, 1 by 6 in this step, 2 by 6, 3 by 6, 4 by 6. So in a 1 in I by n, 1 by 6 is a 0.17. Here a 0.2 by 6 is 0.33. In this 0.5, this 0.67.83, and here 1.00. So now we have to calculate d plus. So d plus formula is I 1 by n minus r I. So 1 by n, sorry, I by n minus r I by n minus r I. 0.7 माइनस 0.27. सो इसमें हम कैसे कैलकुलेट करेंगे कि जो भी हमारा, अगर हमारा ये नंबर 17, हमारा ये वाला नंबर अगर हमारा स्मॉलेस्ट है इससे, तो हम यहाँ पे सिर्फ नेगेटिव साइन शो करेंगे. दिस वन इज ऑल्सो स्मॉलेस्ट ऑफ 49, सो हेयर अगेन द नेगेटिव साइन इज देयर. सो दिस नंबर इज ऑल्सो अ स्मॉलेस्ट है, सो नेगेटिव साइन इज हेयर. But in this case, this number is a bigger one from this number. So we calculate this number. The result is a 0.04. And this one is also a bigger. The result is 0.12. And this one is also bigger. So 0.11. Now D negative formula is Ri minus I minus 1 by N. आर आई माइनस आई माइनस एन बाई एन. सो इसका कैलकुलेशन कैसे होगा? 0.24, 0.32, 0.24, 0.13, 0.04 and 0.06. सो इसमें भी हमने वैसे फॉर्मूले में सिर्फ वैल्यूज ही पुट की हैं. आर आई, दिस वन इज आर आई माइनस आई माइनस वन. आई ये था वन, माइनस वन मतलब जीरो, बाय एन. व्हाट इज एन? एन इज अ टोटल नंबर ऑफ वैल्यू, दैट इज अ सिक्स. सो ऑल द रिजल्टेंट कैलकुलेशंस आर देयर. सो नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज द डी प्लस. डी प्लस क्या था? हमारा मैक्सिमम ऑफ द डी प्लस वैल्यू इज रिटन एज 0.4, 0.12 एंड 0.11. दिस इज अ वैल्यू ऑफ डी प्लस. एंड इसमें हमारी मैक्सिमम वैल्यू कौन सी है डी प्लस में? द मैक्सिमम वैल्यू वी हैव इज अ दिस. सो इसमें मैक्स वैल्यू ऑफ डी प्लस इज इक्वल टू 0.12. नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द डी नेगेटिव वैल्यू. सो डी नेगेटिव वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू द, वॉट इज द डी नेगेटिव वैल्यू? That 0.24, 0.32, 0.24, 13, 0.4. All the d negative values are written here, and we find out the maximum value of d negative is equal to 0.32. इसमें सबसे ज्यादा increasing value कौन सी है हमारी? 0.32. Now डी, हमने डी कैलकुलेट करना है. सो व्हाट इज अ डी? डी का फॉर्मूला मैक्स ऑफ डी प्लस कॉमा डी नेगेटिव. सो मैक्स इज इक्वल टू, डी प्लस में हमारी क्या थी? 0.12, एंड डी नेगेटिव में हमारी क्या थी? 0.32. सो दिस इज नॉट अ आंसर. वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट the bigger value from these and the bigger value from these two value are 0.32. Now what we find out here the alpha value, which is a given, that is 0.05. Now we write here d alpha is equal to 0.05, and 0.05 का हमने एक टेबल वैल्यू डिफाइन की होती है, मतलब एक टेबल में एक वैल्यू डिफाइन की जाती है, विच इज ऑल्सो इफ दिस क्वेश्चन अराइव इन योर एग्जामिनेशन देन इट विल डेफिनेटली गिवन ऑल द वैल्यू ऑफ 0.05. द टेबल वैल्यू ऑफ 0.05 इज 0.521. दिस इज अ टेबल वैल्यू विच विल बी गिवन टू द एग्जामिनेशन ऑल्सो. So now what we do here, compare d value with 0.521, that is 0.32 greater than 0.521. So what we said, compare this value, and this lies in the statistical table. That means this lies in statistical table, and m where m0 is not rejected. If there was a reverse, then it will be rejected. If this value is greater than equal to this value, if this value is greater than this value, then this will not lies in the statistical table where m0 is rejected, but in this solution of this problem m0 is not rejected. So this is a proved of the problem of the KS problem. Thank you.